is not death, where eternal joy endures. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God the Father, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Dear brothers and sisters, God is good
all the time.
And all the time.
God is good and that is nature.
The goodness of the Lord persists. And what we are gathered here to celebrate this afternoon is a life that was lived, a life that was given by God as a gift to Henry Paul. And we will reach, I'm sure, that each one of us present here this afternoon had to partake in. That is why we are here, to thank God for the many years that he lived with dedication in this world, and to pray that he may enjoy also peace in God's kingdom. And so for us who are still pilgrims here on earth, let us ask the Lord to forgive us our failings, such that this offering, this sacrifice of mass that we offer to for our dear brother Henry might also be of benefit to us for our cleansing. I confess to Almighty God,
and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us all our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Thank you. chapter 3, verse 1 to 9. The souls of the righteous are in the hands of God, and no torment will ever touch them. In the eyes of the foolish, they seem to have died, and in their departure was thought to be a disaster. And they are going from us to be their destruction, but they are at peace. For though in the sight of others they were punished, their hope is full of immorality. Having been esteemed a little, they received a great reward, because God tested them and found them worthy of himself. Like gold in the furnace, he tried them, and like a sacrificial burnt offering, he accepted them. In the meantime, in their visitation, they will shine forth, and they will run like sparks in the stubble. They will gather nations and rule over peoples. And the Lord will reign over them forever. Those who trust in him will understand his truth, and the faithful will abide with him in love, because grace and mercy is upon his holy ones, and he watches over his elect. The word of the Lord.
Thank you. disappoint us, because God's love has been poured into our hearts through the Holy Spirit that has been given to us. For while we were still weak, at the right time, Christ died for the ungodly. Indeed, rarely will anyone die for a righteous person, though perhaps for a good person someone might actually dare to die. But God proves his love for us in that while we were still sinners, Christ died for us. Much more surely then, now that we have been justified by his blood, will we be saved through him from the wrath of God. For if while we were enemies, we were reconciled to God through the death of his Son, much more surely, having been reconciled, will we be saved by his life. But more than that, we even boast in God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom we have now received reconciliation. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Brothers and sisters, let us stand up to welcome the gospel.
Especially this church on Saturdays, you know, weddings, You see one bride coming in and another going out. You see another group come rejoicing. Sometimes the bridegroom delays a bit and they get out and another bride enters like that. But today I saw something that was very shocking, that one corpse is being brought into the church while the other has just gotten out. I think it is the first time, very touching experience, but that I think makes myself personally to reflect on life, that not always, of course, does it come in moments of joy, but there are also this difficult moment of pain, a moment of transition that we all have to go through. There ensued one time an argument among three people, and they asked themselves the question, what would be the best time for you to die? And one of them said, me, I wish I had died as a baby, you know, very innocent, so that I go straight to heaven. I don't have to bother with the troubles of the world, with the pains and all that, you know. Why would I have to go through the hassles? So for me, dying would be nice when you're a baby. And then the second one said, me, I would have to die when I've lived my life and I've reached the old age, such that I enjoy all the pleasures of the world. You know, I do investments, make money, and then when I'm an old man, I can eventually say, yeah, I have achieved something in life and die. And then the third one came. He said, for me, I would like to die in the middle ages. Because you know, in the middle ages, you are at the peak of life, and people love you. So you are dead. We leave them still wanting you to be with them. And then the other one started now criticizing the one who started that he wanted to die as a baby, but what would have been the purpose and meaning of your life? When you die, you don't give anything significant. Maybe you have just been given a name and that is all you die with, so why die as a child? And they criticized also the old man, saying, whom do you want again to become a burden to when you cannot walk and you have to be pulled here and there, escorting people always being by your side? Don't you think it is an inconvenience to others? So it is better not to die as an old man. Then the young man, they say, why would you want to leave us in a mess? You know, when we still only need you, why would you choose to die at that age? Dear brothers and sisters, any time is the best time to die, as long as you are prepared for your death. Any time, we all who are present here are candidates of death. Anytime death can visit us. So this teaches us that as we live our life, it must be a preparation for death. Each time you have an opportunity to live, you must take it as a preparation of your death. And that is why the God of the Lord that we have heard in today's gospel, when Jesus presents the Beatitudes, he does not talk about the good things mostly. He talks about negative things, that blessed are those who mourn, blessed are those who are persecuted. Why? Because there is consolation that they will receive from the Lord. So blessed are you who are mourning today, because you will be comforted. The joy will come from the Lord. The joy will come to those who believe that the Lord whom we praise, whom we worship, is the God of the living. He's a God who wants life for all of us. Now one may ask and say, then why must we die? And still our faith gives us a beautiful answer. That for us death is not the end of life, but it is the transformation of life to a form that is eternal. So then we must not be afraid of it, but we must ask God just to give us the courage to make our lives better, to make ourselves always prepared, such that when this experience comes to us, we are never sure, but we find ourselves ready. Okay, say, yes, Lord, here I am. I've just been trying to look through the biography of our dear brother, Henry Paul Maguta, and as you may see in the book yet, he has written a lot in his life. There is a lot of impact he has left. There is a lot of significance that has been revealed through how he lived his life, especially if you look through his curriculum. And that is how we can also leave an impact on this world. That is how we can also prepare ourselves for this moment of the life after. by asking ourselves, for me, what is the footmark I am leaving behind? How have I lived my past life? Has it been of benefit for others? Now, normally we like to say that God only calls the good, that it's only the good people who die. We ask ourselves so and say, but why? Someone wise answered this question and said that if you see people dying and you are still alive, then it means God is still giving you an opportunity to repent, to live your life better. So then death, every time we come to an experience of it, must make us to turn the gaze also to our own selves. Even as we seek God's consolation for the pain of separation, we must remember that it is also a reflection that calls us to look into ourselves and to see that we are living a life that God desires of us. Dear brothers and sisters, as I conclude, we like to pray for God's grace upon the soul of Henry, that he may grant him eternal rest in his kingdom, and to us all, that he may give us the courage and consolation to be ready to face the reality of life with audacity, with hope, and with faith in him. The Lord be with you. Let us now stand up and offer our prayers and petitions for the repose of the soul of them. Dear brothers and sisters, let us call trustingly upon God the Almighty Father, who raised Christ his Son from the dead, for the salvation of the living and the dead. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Our brother Paul Henry received his baptism, the seed of eternal life. May he enjoy the company of the saints forever. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
This our brother, Paul Henry, was nourished by Christ's body, the bread of eternal life. May he rise again on the last day. For this, Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Let us pray for the souls of our families, relations, and benefactors. May they receive the reward of their labors. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Let us pray for all who sleep in the hope of the resurrection. May they be brought into the light of God's presence. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Let us pray for all of you, all of us who have come here today, to pray in the spirit of faith. May we all attain to the kingdom of glory. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray also for the family of Henry, that they may receive consolation through the Lord. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Hail Mary,
full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you.
brothers and sisters, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands, for the praise of the Lord Jesus, for our good and the good of the Church.
Be near, O Lord, we pray, to your servant, Mbakuta, and to God, on whose funeral day we offer you this sacrifice of conciliation, so that should any stain of sin have clung to him, or any human fault have affected him, it may, by your loving gift, be forgiven and wiped away. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It's right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for you are faithful, Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling returns to dust, as an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace. Blessed are we called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, have mercy on me, a chief guest under my roof. As only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life.
Amen.
Thank you.
We await a Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ, who will change our mortal bodies to conform to his glorified body. Let us pray. Grant, we pray, your mighty God, that your servant, Mbabuta Henry Paul, who has journeyed from this world, may by his sacrifice be cleansed and freed from sin, and so receive the everlasting joys of the resurrection, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
So let us now be seated, and I'll ask the MC to come and lead us.
Dear brethren, on the 5th of June 2020, a dark cloud befell us, and we lost our brother, we lost our father, we lost our friend, we lost our boss. But the words of Father Nicholas and the gospel for today gives us a lot of hope that he is with the Lord. Allow me to take this opportunity to thank Reverend Father Nicholas and Father Kennedy for leading us through this Mass. Please, a round of applause for them. Allow me to also thank our choir for the wonderful hymns. Those who knew Mr. Henry Mbabuta, he loved music so much. So the sound of those hymns, I am sure where he is looking at us, smiling. So thank you very much, choir. At this juncture, we want to move to the next session of this ceremony as we celebrate the life of Mr. Henry Mbabuta. My name is Aliverio Mbabuta, and I am going to request the team from Uganda Funeral Services to come and support us as we lay the wreaths, and are being guided in the order in which the wreaths will be laid. The first give us a hymn. Thank you so much. I want to request the children of this side of the altar, please step forward and bid farewell to our dad.
We'll have Matthew, Uganda Association of Microfinance Institutions in Uganda. As CARE International gets closer, then project for financial inclusion for FIRA representative, please get closer, and then there is. Then Health Service Commission.
Come and lay the wreath on behalf of a few, all it seems they are
touch. Please, Reverend Father, come and lay the wreath in honor of this Diana Burton. So dear mourners, thank you so much for showing so much love to Mr. Henry Mokuta, a man loved by many, and a man who loved so many. So at this point I want to request Uganda Funeral Services, they have a song for us, and then we'll move to the next item. Thank you.
Reverend Father, dear mourners in various capacities, on behalf of the Funeral Services, I dearly express our condolences upon the loss of my dear friend, Father, whom God has called to join me. Grant me his soul, rest in that peace, and may the good Lord strengthen me in this right moment as you listen to that song, Never Grow Old, in that beautiful city, where I am as well.
Speeches, kindly keep them short
precise, so that we are able to finish early and then travel. So I want to request a representative of the Leo Mbabuta family to come and make the speech. And this just allow me to request Honorable says Mr. Mbabuta to come and make those remarks on behalf of the family. Thank you very much.
Celebrate Henry, Paul, that today we are celebrating his life. celebrate his life. I want that God that I am available to celebrate his life as at birth and celebrate his peace. I want that God for having given to me a life. Henry was my brother, but I was also want to say he was my son. He reminded me that he was my son, that I was short of being his mother. Up to now, he said it about 3 weeks ago, and up to now I still think about that. But because Henry had brought in my home, and we always welcome to Kunti, celebrate any function of our parents that was there. We make sure that we go there. I would also wish to inform the mourners that what our parents gave us as a gift and a value was to make friends. In this audience, the Kabamas are here, the who are here, they were friends of Henry. They also turned out to be my friends because they were always coming around to my home with their friend Henry. I also want to celebrate Henry that he was a good worker, and where there are issues, we will consult him. Somehow I have some skills in public service management. So you come and consult us. And I would say, no, 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 that direction don't take the other one. Indeed, I think the Minister of Finance is going to talk about him and talk very much on how he was a good officer, which I think he was, and I celebrate him for being having been a good officer. But I also want to remind the Minister of Finance that when people work hard and work well, they should be promoted. A month ago, when he came from India, he said, my dear sister, my dear mommy, I want to discuss that I've had a good career and I've served the government. He said, yes, you serve the government, you also serve the government. He said, I have one little message that you keep and take and tell society of the public service of Uganda. That when people work well, they should be advanced. In career, they should be actually rewarded. And his reward was not financial. His reward was to elevate him to another level. I got a little bit upset because my career was to promote people, my career was to make sure that people are promoted, and to see my brother saying that he was not advanced as fast as he thought, let the future civil servants that follow him be advanced timely. And be advanced so that as they use the service, they have no regrets. That's the little message I want to give you from finance. Because that's why he worked all his life. And he did wonderful jobs. But I thought that I would not leave that one out. Because by telling it to me, it means it was at the heart. That he thinks he performed very well, and then promotions did not move faster. I want to celebrate my brother because together we developed helping the community, and he actually put in a lot of effort to develop the community. In Maramo, Kashai, I think when we mind did not have to work his banana plantation and brought me a banana. What I want to say is that we should reflect and think about our friends and think what else can we do beyond saying hello and salam aleikum. We need to see each other, help each other, and I want to conclude that did I say Henry was married in this church? Yes. Yeah. And I am happy that Gloria is here, talk about her wedding here, and I want to thank God that I was a witness to that wedding. I see many of our friends in the audience, many of you. I see many of our friends, I see many of our relatives from Dr. Sezi, my late husband who waited here, and I see many of all our relatives and friends and colleagues. I want to thank you very, very, very much for having to pray for Henry, and may he rest in peace with his family.
Standing with us, not only the ministry, but to each one of you. Yvonne Namara, Karenji Samantha, Brandy Ina Mbakuta, Karuka Sabrina, Akawanzi Isabella, Murungi Jeremiah,
Thank you.
fellow mourners, the priest, all protocols that. Let me take this opportunity to welcome you to the final celebrations of Mulano and Henry, Bakutako, Biamutisha, Mugogoma. My speech is in six categories, but don't worry, as a golfer, I'll try to do two under par. Number one, as a son, he was a very helpful son. He looked after his parents up to their beginnings. So really, they were happy and we thank him for that. Number two, as a brother, I liked the way he related with his siblings, especially at Christmas. Whenever they would be together, you would wonder, like, first and last born, and like, wow. So, as a friend, he has very many friends. He was quiet, jolly. So some people would wonder, this quiet man, how does he, like, relate with everyone like this? There are three critical friends. Herbert Whitfield, those as they grew up together, Jeffrey Mutisha, and Lars Kashute. Those are the people I found him as his friends, and they are the people that saw him last before he departed. So, that one shows that he was good at making friends and sustaining the friendship. Now, when we come to work, which is number four, he was like workaholic. Even in his last days, he was like, okay, when we finish this and I start chemotherapy and work, he was requesting his supervisors that they set up a desk at home so that when he's not sleeping, he can do work for his department. So you can see how committed he was. And actually now we're competing for space of bookstroke policies versus all trophies and everything else. Number five was a father, man. Mulani Wanjo was an example. He loved all the children equally. And he will always make sure that he provides their needs. And in his last words, he said that those who want his help, they must be under the same roof. And the door is open for him to know. Those who have been declared and not declared, the door is wide open. I'd like to thank my fellow helpers. The Lord will help me through this. Number six, as a husband. 24 years ago and 9 months, we were in this church. Precisely in 3 months and 6 days, we are going to celebrate 25 years in marriage. But unfortunately, the Lord decided to do otherwise. But I thank God for it. Now the last one is sickness. The way God did this thing is that when he came up, he got that news on 5th May. He lost his bread, his last bread on 5th June, precisely a month. And I was with him in and out of the hospital for 24 days. So which summarizes everything that each day represented 1 year in our marriage. And the good thing is that he committed himself to the Lord.
Jesus, Jesus,
times he needed support. But as you can see, he was forgotten. But in one way, God gave me the strength to be able to support him when he wanted to move around. Some people might wonder, why am I not crying? Why should I cry when I know he's in a better place? He committed his life to God. So crying is basically mukabila geena. And it's not right. And I'd like to call upon my fellow sisters. If your husband has wronged you and he says sorry, forgive and forget. Turn that page, start a new chapter, and the Lord will see you through. May he so rest in time of peace.
Thank you so much. Next will be a representative from National Tax Storage Corporation, Gloria Mabuta's employer. But as they come, allow me to read the condolence message from Uganda Microfinance Regulatory Authority. At Omra, we were saddened to learn that our founder and friend passed away. Would like to extend our deepest condolences to you, or especially the family, during these difficult times. Please know that we are keeping you in our thoughts. I hope that your memories then can bring you some comfort as you walk through this grieving process. Throughout the time, he has worked with the microfinance sector, Henry showed wisdom, kindness, and courage. He has been at the center of the microfinance policy and regulation for Uganda and other countries, especially East Africa. It is my wish for us all that we face this loss, we draw on those wonderful qualities, be wise as we reflect, be kind to ourselves, and be courageous in this moment of grief. As UMRA, we are contributing Uganda shillings, 5 million shillings, through Liba Mabuta to support the family during these trying moments. For God and my country, signed by Edith Tusuvira, Executive Director, on behalf of the Board of Management and staff of the Uganda Microfinance Regulatory Authority, representative from National Time, please come and make your remarks shortly. Thank you. Okay. Next.
Gloria became part of us. Gloria. have a whole family to absorb national water. So national water villages keep supporting the family. In the world of money. So when we are here at home, we are we don't have much say. I think the contributions we have already made in terms of budget expenses. My name is Jackson Chester-Yabia, a former general manager of the area national water, now senior manager of the office. But allow me, my fellow staff, to say thanks. Sister John Yalanga, Chirunzi, can you come up here? Why I call these people up here is because they have worked very closely with Henry for the years.
In fact, what we are going to miss
was that Henry did not write a book on all these wonderful experiences, the information, the data he had. So that is something that I am going to miss because I would have shared it with the rest of the world. I don't even know that there is anybody who can write a PhD and match the knowledge that Henry had. So we are going to miss him so much. I think I want also to mention that in his last days, he worked very closely with Mr. Moses Sophocles, who has actually been around since he came back from India. He's been with the family throughout all this time. And then I think he also worked with John and the Rwanda. Before joining the Rwanda, we went to the tax policy department. But they were together in the financial services department. And he has worked, I think, all his life with Lance Ashujera, whom we know very well. There have been two professionals with very deep knowledge in microfinance and rural finance. And I think they have made a very good impact on the country. He's worked with Mr. Kakama in a lot of areas, in budgeting, because he was also very good in budgeting. He has worked with Madam Harris, Wanyera, especially with issues that are related to aid, and with Mr. Ashaba. All of us are very involved with him, and we are going to miss him so much. Our accounting officer has been there during the trying moments that Henry has had to really offer him helping. I want to assure the people who are here that in the Ministry of Finance, we are a family. We never let our own down. Henry had a lot of issues, but we always sit down with him as a family and resolve them. He is so blessed in eternal peace. The Honourable Secretary has asked me to say the word as the most senior supervisor and for him to offer a privilege. Yesterday I had the privilege to speak at the vigil and I mentioned that Mr. Maruta had two families. The biological family, I would like to grow with you, but there was also us. And I dare mention to you yesterday that he probably spent more time with us than with you. I'd like to request that I introduce the inner family of Mr. Maruta at the ministry, the staff of the Financial Services Department. Please stand up. These people have sat with this gentleman every day. The other secretary would like the other members of staff of the ministry to also stand up.
Listen to the various speeches tomorrow, there will be evidence of what I'm saying.
May his soul rest in peace.
Travel time and the meeting point.
you get into a road called the road that goes to Kanungu. Then you drive a few kilometers and get to a trading center called Katoho. You see a big signpost. You take your right and then get to the next trading center called Nyarugugu. And from Nyarugugu, you turn your left onto Mbabuta Road. The locals named it after Mbabuta, so it's called Mbabuta Road. In fact, even when you go to Ujini and say, I am going to Mbabuta Road, majority of the people are aware of that place and they will be able to direct you. Lastly, allow me to thank church for allowing us to accord us this time to honor our friend, our brother, our father, our boss, this respect, and may Henry's soul rest in eternal peace. Thank you so much. All my pleasure.
So thanks to you all for coming to pay your last respects to Henry. Particular thanks to the family of you who have supported. And I would like to thank God that you are all strong, especially Gloria and Jane. And we pray that God's peace may continue remaining with you all through life. Let us now stand for the morning prayers. Dear brothers and sisters, it is our solemn duty to carry out in the traditional manner God's faithful people, preparing of this body for burial. As we do so, we call trustfully upon God, from whom all creation has life. May He, in due time, by His power, bring to resurrection with all the saints the body of this our brother Henry, which in His gravity we prepare for burial. May God unite His soul with those of the saints and faithful departed. May He be given merciful judgment, so that we live from death, free from punishment, recognized to the Father, carried in the arms of the Good Shepherd, He may deserve to enter fully everlasting happiness in the company of the eternal King, together with all the saints.
Alleluia.
Amen.
strengthened by the sure hope that he, together with all who have died in Christ, will rise again with Christ on the last day. We thank you for all the blessings with which you endowed this servant of yours in his life on earth. They are for us too a token of your love and of the blessed union of the saints in Christ. Listen then, Lord, in your mercy to our prayers, that the gates of paradise may be opened to your servant, that we who are left may console one another with words of faith, until we all meet in Christ and share with you and our dear brother eternally, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord.
Amen.
May he rest in peace.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Let us go forth in the peace of Christ.
Amen. Spirit of God.
Thank you. Pause. Nda kula kazi message. Nda kula. Bright again bwake muite embalala kwa hiyo kolotiza kwa hiyo. Yes, pillars.
Katafuka tafatu ino mbulezo yu na kani. Bright umbe angu.
Eh, bright wa jokuri. Nda kula. Nda kula 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 kula.
Thank you.